ourselves. Previously. Did we push ourselves?
Like on the camera, maybe?
Yeah.
I thought it was through chat.
Did we actually, like, have a browser?
I don't think so. I think it was just, like, however
you watched through here. Or maybe it was on a laptop.
Oh, we did have a laptop open to see comments.
Yeah,
so.
Are we having double voices right now if I have this on?
That's a good question.
Okay, this is microphone one.
For the past month, my co-star...
Rated E for everyone.
What's up?
Okay, we're live.
Hi.
Now. Wow, we had a lot of technical weirdness going on back here. I mean, everything's working, but nothing is, like, syncing together.
Yeah.
Hi, guys. Anyways, this is little Jackalope here with our intern.
Tess.
You can see my hands double over here. This is weird. Wow. Okay. Can you grab those two and
yes.
then this thing right there? And I'm going to get my pie out of the way. We are live.
What did I just grab? You couldn't see it, right?
That's okay.
Yeah, whatever.
You put this someplace out of the way, like on the floor.
Cool.
That works. Oh, a battery.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, there we are.
Yeah.
Woo. Okay, good. We are here. Can you guys hear us okay? If you can hear us and you're not reading our lips, what is Nancy Drew's dog's name? Put it in the chat feed. In the meantime... Well, it doesn't make any sense if they can't hear me. Thank you, Rooftop Song. Thank you very much. Great.
Whoa, yeah, all right.
Whoa!
What's like, how go?
You guys have pizza and Euros. I'm kind of jealous. But
what?
Actually, I have pizza here, too, so, I mean, I could eat it. But welcome to the stream. If you're brand new, we don't normally start off all like this. But welcome. We're glad to have you. We are going to be playing Stay Tuned for Danger today.
Yay!
Woo! Which we're playing it now in honor of it being available.
Yes.
Re-released on our website for the digital download only. Because we do have a workaround. It's such an older game that when the newer operating systems were coming out for the PC, it was not working well, so it was such a trouble, such a hassle for people to get it and play it that we just took it off our store entirely. And now we do have a workaround for it, which we've made a video for you. If you actually get the game and you want to play it again, you can do it. You just got to follow the instructions exactly in order for it to work.
And say no to DirectX. No.
Say no to DirectX.
That one.
Say
no. Yeah, we get that. We get that kind of... email from like tech support and stuff. We get that kind of thing all the time. So yeah, if it asks to install DirectX, say no. Click the no. I will install it myself. So yeah.
Yes.
There you go.
So
now you know.
Exactly what she said. So we are going to be playing for about an hour and a half until about 5. So if you look at your clocks right now, it's an hour and 25 minutes from now is when we're going to call it a day. This game is really short, which is why we're only playing it for 2 days instead of our typical 3. And I know a lot, we're going to take a break about halfway through, so maybe in about 40 minutes we're going to stop for a 5 or 10 minute break, depending on how we're doing.
Yep.
And it'll be intermission, so you can get yourself snacks, take a break, whatever. But when we get back from intermission, we're going to give away a prize.
Yep.
And then at the end of the stream today, we're going to give you another prize. We're actually doing 2 prizes today.
Ooh.
I didn't tell you about that.
Oh,
but,
this is cool.
I was told to break these up into a prize and then prize.
All right.
So that's what we're doing.
Cool.
Here, show off that one.
All right. Here's prize number uno. One.
Number one.
Woo!
It's what
a
is
physical,
that?
Physical copy of Stay Tuned for Danger, so.
Yes. It's an actual copy of this game. And by the way, what makes this one special right here is that, yes, it's the physical copy. We do not sell this anymore. I actually went digging through our boxes with Jean.
Oh, nice. And you discovered
and
it.
And I found these.
In the depths.
It's an extra one that was just lying around, and I got permission to give it away to you guys. So
Ooh.
It's a physical disc. It's on the it's in the DVD case. Yay.
Lovely.
Unopened. It still has a sticker on it, so it's not like a used one. Ooh. It's still good. So that's the first prize. We're going to give that away after the intermission. You want to figure out how we're going to do that? You want to do random, or you want to do keyword, or...
We could do another keyword thing.
Okay, we'll do the keyword for that one, and then we'll do, like, a random selection for the second prize at the end of the day.
Okay.
Yeah.
Perfect.
So in order to win... Wait, why don't you write down a keyword that... Have you played this game?
I have, yes. I love this. This is, like, one of my favorites.
Write down a keyword, but don't show the camera.
All right.
So, in order to win the game throughout this first half of the Twitch party stream, we are going to be looking for a keyword. You guys have to be chatting in the chat feed. Just conversations. Don't just throw out stuff. It's going to happen in a casual conversation that you will be typing in the chat feed. So, it'll come up. So just keep asking questions, pointing out stuff in the game, helping us with puzzles, and just chatting with your fellow friends, asking us questions, and that keyword will show up. Someone will say it. And if it really does not show up, we will be prompting you guys into discussion about things, and whoever says it first that shows up in our chat feed,
yes,
what we see, is going to be declared the winner. By the end of intermission, will be the winner of this prize. Now, throughout the entire today party, anyone who participates at least once in the chat feed, at least one comment. It doesn't have to be a lot. Doesn't have to be anything special. Yeah. As long as you're here, and we see that you're present by at least one chat, you're entered for a chance to be randomly selected. Randomly, totally random. To win this second prize pack, we have this duo set of a Nancy Drew journal, which you've seen is also available in our store, and it also comes with this unopened Hardy Boys Nancy Drew Season 1 DVD set from the 1970s, which I'm excited about because I actually really like this show.
Yeah. Sean Cassidy.
I prefer Parker Stevenson. But that's because I prefer Frank, though, too. Look. It says there's a color poster inside.
Ooh. Is it like one of those felt ones or anything? Or is it
I think it's just paper.
Oh.
A printout paper.
Either way, it's awesome.
Yeah. Of the Hardy Boys, which is super cool.
Dreamy.
Oh, so yes. Dreamy. Yes. Anyway, so those are the prizes.
All right, and I think this is a secret word, maybe? Possibly? Yes?
Yes.
Cool.
That'll work.
All right.
That'll do.
Woo.
I'm turning on my phone so I can see you guys and respond to your guys' comments. So if I'm ever I know. I have. Commercials, yeah. I'm just annoying you. We should probably get on to playing now. Wow. Am I even logged on as me? Yes. No, don't show them the word. They're asking to show the word.
All right.
Oh, mute.
Commercials, yeah.
That's so bizarre. Can one of the prizes be Frank washing a car instead?
We'll see what we can do. We'll see. No promises.
I should totally make that and do, like, poster printouts of each month calendar so you can have... You should make it yourself. We'll just do it like a PDF document or something.
That would be beautiful.
All right. Wow. Mute. I don't want to hear myself again.
Are okay, you sure?
But if you wanted to chat back with people and type stuff, you can, but you can look there and you can look there. We're putting on our handy dandy.
Earphones,
because we are going to start playing.
Yeah.
Oh, right. And a few quick things, you guys. If you are new to the chat, and Twitch parties. Couple quick things. Please do not post any spoilers, which
yes.
Spoilers include answers to puzzles and who the culprit is. Just in case there's anyone here who has not played the game before and would like to, well, they'll see the answer at the end of this party anyways.
Yeah.
But don't spoil it for anyone. And then two, please keep the chat feed to a PG level in case there are younger people watching. Thank you very much. Mm. Okay. Olive Garden.
I know
we didn't get to go to Olive Garden.
There's still time.
There's still time. Okay. How come Skype did not quit on me? I told it 3 times to quit.
It's just not a quitter. Skype is not
If Skype, if someone Skypes me in the middle of this feed, it'll pop up right in front of you. Where's the game? It's right here.
All right. Woo, here we
go. Okay, good. I can still see you. I actually, last time I played this, I turned the music off.
Right, I forgot. You're celebrating your 70th birthday next month? Oh, you are so sassy. But that's what I love about you. Sassy. Right.
Nice.
That is actual quote from one of the characters in the game. I'm going to try to cue it up so you hear it. But that was actually, cheeseburgers. You guys are funny. Now, I could play on Master because there's only like 2 puzzles and it's way more fun, I think. But for the sake of time, Junior Detective.
Right on.
Dear Bess, you'll never guess who I'm visiting in New York. Maddie Jensen, your favorite soap star from Light of Our Love. Maddie is renting Aunt Eloise's apartment in New York. And after hearing about my last case, Secrets Can Kill, Maddie called to invite me up here. According to Maddie, Rick Arlen is getting death threats, but he won't go to the police, so she wants me to do some investigation work. Can you imagine anyone not liking Rick Arlen, daytime's cutest hunk? I have a sneaking suspicion, though, that there's more to this case than meets the eye. Call you later, Nancy.
All right.
New York! You guys, this is what New York's map looks like.
It's beautiful.
Yeah.
Central Park is screaming.
I actually looked up this location in real and on Google Maps to see if it's an actual place.
Is it?
I mean, it's a real place, but there's like no 1226 version of it, and it's not like homes or like businesses or something.
That's a shame.
Come on in, Nancy. The door's open.
I didn't even knock. How'd she know I was here?
She's like telepathic or something.
Well, let's snoop through
X-ray
everything.
Vision.
X-ray vision. Cute. Look at these little fake little flat flowers. I've never noticed those before. Looks like she made them out of paper.
It's probably from Rick.
Yes. did we freeze? We didn't freeze, did we?
Oh.
Did I freeze?
Mm-hmm.
I think I froze.
Can you... Oh.
Well, I know on my computer.
Oh,
I can't look through her mail now, huh? My camera has frozen.
Oh, no.
My camera's not working. I am forever stuck in this ponder.
Very contemplative pose, though, yeah.
He is. Of course, now I'm waving and... Hi! Nancy, while you were out, Ned called. He asked me to tell you to call him the first chance you get. By the way, he sounds cute. Ned called. Oh, let's talk to Ned.
Woo!
1, 5, 2, 3, 5, 5, 5, 4, 3, 5, 7.
I definitely like memorized some of the numbers like over the years of playing.
Hello?
Guess who?
Nancy! First you leave me to visit your aunt in Florida, and now you're in New York. By the time you get back to River Heights, I'll be an old man.
Unicorn Princess, thank you. I'm doing fine. Thank you. Wow, that was hard to say. Gosh.
That's okay. I'll still love you.
Even if I'm bald and wearing dentures?
What do you think, you guys? Should we say no or yes? Are we loyal to the end, or do we dump him after he looks ugly?
Oh, that's a tough call. I don't know. I like Ned. I think we should be nice to him.
Let's be nice. Let me be nice.
Of course, Ned. Even if you're toothless and hairless.
You're so sweet. Strange, but sweet. So, Hannah told me about the investigation you're working on. Sounds neat, but kind of dangerous. Anything I can help you out with?
Well, I'm getting along so far.
Okay, I'll let you get back to your sleuthing.
We should dump him for Dave.
Kit and Ann, we have not even met Dave at this point in our lives, as Nancy Drew. You guys, I'm gonna bump out real quick.
Yeah.
Because my picture froze.
Oh.
Hey, look, there I am!
Yay! Is it working for you guys? Can you see? Is she still contemplative? Or is she moving around?
I'm alive! I'm moving! Oh, thank you. I'm glad to be alive again.
It's pretty rad. Ooh.
Miss Manhattan.
Wow.
Look, some guys... This looks familiar. I wonder what this is from. Like that's Maddie right there.
I don't know. Oh. Yeah, now I saw. I'd never noticed that before. Oh, yeah, there she's there.
There she is again. Important people.
Nice. I like that.
Oh, this looks fun.
Reenactment, right on.
Yes. Anyway, she's done a lot of great, important things, huh?
Yeah, quite the resume. All in pictures, too.
Yeah, in photo frames and everything. Look, awards and stuff.
Nice. Oh.
You gotta love the 90s graphics.
Welcome to New York, Nancy. I'm really glad you could come out here on such short notice.
I'm happy to help in any way I can. Aunt Eloise told me that someone on the set is getting death threats.
Well, for the past month, my co-star, Rick Arlen, has been getting these awful death threats.
Photoshop.
First, we all shrugged it off. You get the occasional odd letter in this business. But then they started to get weird.
You're right, you guys. They were all photoshopped in.
Yeah.
The reason the door looks like a hole in the wall. We're going to appreciate the low Photoshop quality. I mean, there's probably Photoshop version 1. Actually, no, I don't think it was even Photoshop that they were using. Something else. It was either Coral or some other older program. But yeah, this was like a big deal when this game came out. I remember when it first came out, and I played PC games a lot, and having a PC game with 3D characters was a huge deal. Even though, I mean, I loved it when this was like this. Now it's like the art has gotten so much better over the years.
Mm-hmm. It's amazing how fast technology progresses. Like, dang.
Mm-hmm.
Weird?
They're totally bizarre. Not only did he get letters, but somebody sent him a box of poison chocolates, a broken watch, and then there's that whole thing with the teleprompter.
MS Paint, yes, Gene Axby. Yeah, we used MS Paint. Do you have skills like that with MS Paint?
If so, that's props to you.
Good job.
I applaud you.
Good job.
She heaps, the stream is going until, I believe, 5:30?
Yeah.
So what happened with the teleprompter?
Well, I was reading the teleprompter during a scene with Rick. All of a sudden, my lines read, "You're going to die a horrible death, Rick." At the time, we all thought it was some sick joke, but nobody admitted to doing it.
Did Rick go to the police?
No, and that's the problem. No one is taking any of this seriously. Especially Rick. He thinks nothing will ever hurt him.
Someone sent him poison chocolates?
Rick's a major chocoholic. His fans and friends are always sending him boxes of candy. But these chocolates were so nasty, Rick spit them out. I've never seen Rick say no to chocolate before.
Who says no to chocolate?
Only crazy people. I'm sorry. Unless you're allergic to chocolate, in which case I'm very sorry.
Tell me about the letters.
Well, the first ones had the letters cut out of magazines, you know, like on a ransom note. They were all signed by someone named B.T. Kaiser. Somehow the news leaked out and the press totally jumped on them. Then they started getting ugly and twisted. Nancy, I'm running late. I need to get to the studio. Hey, why don't you come over and visit? I'll leave a visitor's pass for you at the security desk.
Yes.
Oh, before I forget, here's a copy of the house keys. I'm always losing my keys, so I've got plenty of copies. I'll write the studio's address on your map. Just catch a taxi cab outside and show them the map. They'll know how to get there.
You say dogs say no to chocolate? Actually, the dog I grew up with, her name was Jasmine, and she's a Husky Shepherd mix, but she loved chocolate.
You didn't give her chocolate, did you?
We didn't give it to her, no. No, we'd have Christmases and birthday parties where we would gift boxes of chocolate to each other, and if anybody left their boxes of chocolate within her reach, like her body length, if she was just down her hind legs, she would sniff it out and find it.
Oh my gosh.
She would go up to the Christmas tree where the box of presents were, and she would sniff out which one had chocolate inside, tear open the box, and get to the chocolate.
Oh my goodness.
Yes, she was sick a little bit afterwards, but she never died.
That's good. Did she consume, like, all of it, or just, like, part of the box?
All of the chocolate inside. Oh, she opened goodness. Up the wrapper, tore apart the cellophane off the box.
Oh, no.
And ate every single piece of chocolate.
That's late. I'm glad she was okay. But then the chocolate is gone for everyone else, you know.
Sad. So sad.
That hurts me.
Annual Soap Stars Award.
Ooh.
Best Actress.
In 1999. Congrats, Maddie.
Yeah, look, she's got three.
Ooh.
Nice.
I need something to make this work.
And just about everything in this game has, like, Nancy Drew brand NDTV.
That's awesome.
So that's, we should keep a tally. We should write a tally.
Should, yeah. I think.
So, one for the TV. Okay, you guys, tell me you've got one of these lamps in your home.
Come on.
Ooh, let's read her stuff.
What does she say?
Milk will spill, love will vanish. Okay. You be Serena, I'll be Rory.
Okay.
And I'll just narrate. Rory finds himself alone in Serena's townhouse. Among some books and magazines, Rory picks up a diary of on a coffee table. Serena enters.
Oh, Rory, you scared me. What are you doing here?
I was hoping to find you here. I've been making myself right at home, love.
I see you found my personal diary. That's rude.
That wasn't in the script. Well, yeah, you left it out on the table for all the world to see. What was I supposed to do?
Well, you could have shown a little respect for my privacy and left it alone.
You know me better than that. Your business is my business, babe.
Wow. Attention. It's crazy. I'd be a little miffed if someone did that. Although, yeah. Who leaves their diary in the middle of their...
That's true.
Tess takes over days of our lives.
We should just do one totally Nancy Drew spin-off, and I am frozen on the screen again.
Oh, but no! Still just as contemplative as before. It's great.
Yeah. Lots of pictures of her and Rick.
Hmm.
Oh, a remote. I'll take that. What to expect from TV's hottest couple.
Ooh. And Maddie.
Article about Maddie. She's very close with her mother. We're best friends.
Nice.
But my mom, I'd never have the opportunity to start in this business.
Yay, Sheeps! You finally downloaded Codes and Clues?
Nice! You got Codes and Clues!
Good for you!
Woot.
That's a great app.
I'm frozen
again.
You
all again. Should get it.
In the momento. No. Hey, am I working again? That's good. That's so weird. All I have to do is bounce out and bounce back in. I don't know why it freezes like that.
Maybe it's like in combination with the game or something.
HP fan Elsa? You mean like Elsa from Frozen? Oh, Frozen, I get it. Ha 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 ha.
You should just let it go.
Nice.
Thank you.
Okay,
I'll
so this
be here
is
all week.
This is a real life picture with that Maddie was inserted into. And here is Megan Geiser, who was the CEO and the president at the time.
That's awesome. I'm licking the hair.
Maddie, I'm writing this letter because you never call me. You can't be that busy not to phone your poor mother, can you? I saw your photo on Soap Opera Journal at the store. You'd think that my own daughter would at least send me one copy. Send me a copy. I was devastated to see that your picture is so much smaller than Rick's. What makes him more important than you? Darling, you must remember that you are the real star.
That's right.
Of that show. And it's about time we show the world that you are number one. I will not allow you to ever play second fiddle to that man. Without your talent, he'd be nothing. Remember that. And remember this the person who paid for all your acting lessons for all 3 years.
Wow.
Mother.
Thanks, Mother.
So there's a little pressure for Mom to be number one and better than Rick.
Yes.
Hmm.
Because Rick is a hunk. That's right, Logan the burrito.
annual daytime soap opera gala.
Ooh, fancy.
Manhattan Country Club.
Nice.
Check this out, you guys. Looky, looky, an eyeball.
That's kind of creepy.
And it's the date is circled for Friday the 13th. Have you guys seen this? And then, of course, once you click on it, poof, it's gone.
Oh.
Our programmers were weird back then.
It's kind of a fun Easter egg, though.
But it is fun. We do appreciate the oddities that our design team would put back in. Put stuff in here. And then when you back out, it comes back.
That's so cool. I think I remember finding that, too. I was like, oh, that's weird. And then I thought, yeah.
I love desks Ooh. Like this. I have a hidden compartment.
Whoa.
Dear Rick. So it looks like a letter she's writing to Rick. There is so much that I want to tell you and confide in you, but I don't know. I am afraid where this would lead. I am truly, that's an insertion, in love with you, but how can I be sure that you feel the same way? I think we both know the answer, but I think you refuse to admit it. You refuse to admit that you are truly in love with me, and I think that makes you scared, afraid. Afraid of the commitment this would mean. Why must you continue playing the part of the confirmed bachelor, constantly looking for another date? We both know you're not happy with this past, but you still play it. You still play the... What's that word?
You still play the... Incurable? Oh, incurable romantic.
And all you really want is a lifetime of love. I am ready for this commitment.
Whoa.
Maddie wants to marry Rick. I wonder if she actually sends the revised letter to him.
It's a good thing she didn't send that one. Ooh, more stuff.
A Valentine card. Oh, from Rick. Dearest Maddie, my love, my one and only, mi amore. You are the sparkle in my eye, the song in my heart, the woman of my dreams. When I hear your soft voice fill the air, it sounds like a chorus of angels. A sound that I'm missing right now as I write this. My life is darkened and full of despair without you. I cannot bear the thought of separating from you for more than a second. How I miss the warmth of your smile, the way the light shines through your hair and your eyes. I could gaze into those twin pools of beauty forever.
Oh my gosh.
Nothing more would give me such pleasure. I will sadly count the hours until our next rendezvous. Until then, sign me in love, Rick.
You know, if it weren't for the time that this was made, I would think you just went online and found up all the different pickup lines and cliches and just wrote them on the card.
Oh, there's another one.
Oh, well, hello.
No words that even the greatest of poets could render with pen and paper could do any justice to describe my love for you. I truly cannot imagine what life had been before I met you, but...
Rick should write Hallmark cards.
Yes!
True.
Truly cannot imagine what life had been before I met you, but I... What I can't imagine is a lifetime of love with you. A lifetime of stolen kisses, cherished sweet nothings, and your warm laughter that fills my soul with joy. Will you be mine, Maddie? That is all I ask. Your hand and your heart and nothing more. Forever yours, Rick.
Aww, what a sap.
So they do secretly love each other. What's the problem?
It's locked. It's locked.
Classic.
You guys. I think maybe during like intermission I can, or maybe tomorrow I can queue up. So there was, just FYI, for those of you who know this, this drawer right here, originally in the design of the game, it was meant to be opened. There's more stuff in here. But, you know, being an older game and being a company that was small and was just starting out, there were a few glitches with these games, a few bugs, and the key didn't actually get programmed to be found hidden someplace for you to actually get. I know where the key is, and I know how to, at least I thought I did, know how to queue it up in the back end, in the build, which only I can do here in the office because we've got the resources for. I might be able to throw the key into the scene, and look, I froze again.
Oh no.
And open up that drawer just for you guys to see.
That would be really cool.
I'll have to play with that. I might have to wait for that until tomorrow, though. I'll get it queued up and then saved.
That would be so awesome.
Well, that's a fascinating look on my face.
There we go.
Okay, let's go back.
At least it's an easy fix and it's not lagging like crazy like last time. So.
Yeah, I don't know what's wrong. I set it to the lowest resolution, too. A remote! Whew. Beautiful. What a boring TV. Okay, anyways, let's get out of here. No, wait. There's more things!
Look at all the magazines!
Cheddar magazine! Oh, see, now this needs to be a giant poster.
Oh my.
This needs to be someone's giant poster on their bedroom wall.
I like he looks like he's singing in some of these.
Like,
It's just cheesing super hard. This should be a poster that people could download from the website.
You know what? I'm going to look for it later and see if we've got the original art. Is that someplace I can bump up the resolution to be printable, I think.
That would be amazing.
Maybe. Last days for Rory Danner.
He's so shiny, yeah.
Say what?
He's so shiny.
He is. He's got so much gel in his hair. He's like a Ken doll.
He is. A beautiful Ken doll.
Rumors are rampant that Rick Arlen is breaking his contract with Worldwide Broadcasting and settling his sights on a career in film. Oh boy.
Ooh.
We should ask him about that.
We should. I agree.
One more picture looking.
Nice.
Wow.
That's cute.
I wonder whose pictures those really are.
I know.
I'm kind of curious. Oh, look, they're all friends.
Nice.
Whoever that guy is, Maddie, Rick, and whoever that is. Okay, let's get out of here now.
Let's do it.
Worldwide Broadcasting.
Taxi!
Where can I take you today, miss?
1999 Broadway, please.
Yeah, what time is it?
It is...
Can you see?
No.
You guys, I need to show you a picture of this later. Because there's actually a place here in downtown Bellevue that we took a picture of to create this design. Have I shown it to you?
I don't think you have, no.
Really? I showed it to Taylor, I know that.
Oh.
Hello. Can I have a donut?
I would love a donut. Let's do donuts.
Donut. Meet Rick Arlen in person, you guys!
Woo! Friday, super November exciting. 20th. From 3 to 4:30. It's a very short window, but yeah.
Yeah. Oh, wait, they have a website. www.wwbnetwork.com. I should write that down and see if, someone would...
Where is it?
I don't know if that's, if that could be a real website by now. wwbnetwork.com.
Ooh, yeah.
Oh, look, there they are. Superstars. Other superstars.
Lovely.
Artists from the company Prom Photos. I don't know, maybe. Magazines. No, letters are cut out. Lots of letters cut out.
Oh my.
There's something
kind of a sloppy job, too, cutting out. That would be a little weird, because, when people cut stuff out like that, it looks like you're going to make a ransom note, you know? And
yeah.
So that would be really weird to watch someone just cut stuff out like that. Like, what are you doing?
Ooh, the gift shop's on 3 in 350.
Let's go to 350.
Yes.
Let's get a gift. Like
or
a mug.
We could go to makeup at 182.
Ooh. We could go to the gift shop and then... Or we could go do makeup and then go to the gift shop.
Yes. And then go to wardrobe.
This is like a shopping trip.
There's a cafeteria on 300, too.
Oh, sweet. Let's just skip everything and go to the cafeteria.
Oh, yeah.
Food.
It's a real elevator.
Ooh.
Or is that a hallway?
I can't tell. It looks like it's a hallway.
Oh, okay. Because that's a giant elevator if that ever was one.
So Minecraft, that person says it's a real website and you typed it in?
On economic crisis.
Ooh.
It's a website about working women.
Ah, that's cool.
Oh, neat.
Fun fact. Oh, more missing letters.
If you don't see this, there might be something missing. You think? Aw, cute.
Aw.
And gardening.
Final flourish. Do they have french fries in the cafeteria? Unicorn Princess Nikki? I don't know. We should go look.
Someone said Cocoa Kringles flavored something and donuts and french fries. A Cocoa Kringle donut would be amazing. I don't know how to make donuts, though.
Ooh, probably let's deep fry everything.
Let's go this way.
Can I help you?
Okay. No, I'm pretty capable of helping myself.
Hey, dude.
Can I help you?
Nothing, I'm just looking.
Oh, he just looks so happy. Look at that smile.
That's a great smile.
Yes, Maddie Jensen left a visitor's pass for me. It should be listed under Nancy Drew.
Here you are. You'll need to sign for it. You'll need to come to this desk every time you enter so I can log you in.
Cool.
Oh, I love this. I like seeing the different... So, this guy right here.
Yeah.
Jay Cleason.
Mm-hmm.
His name is Jan Cleason, and he was actually one of the board members at the time.
Ooh.
Kim Ulmer, that's a change of her name because her actual name was Chris Ulmer.
Ooh.
And she was one of the artists at the time.
That's cool.
L.A. Adamo. I'm not sure. I do know that Adamo is like Latin for love or something.
Oh. That's so cool to find all these. Yeah, you wonder how many people.
Hair and nail design.
Ooh.
Massage therapy. I'm talking to her.
Well, let's go to Olivia, please.
Have a nice day.
Nice.
Aww.
One of my favorite characters in this game.
Mildred W. Strathorn. Just a fun fact, you guys. This character was put in this game as, what's the proper word for that?
Like, she's extra something.
She's supposed to, like, portray Millie Benson.
No way!
Yeah, that was the intent with Mildred Strathorn.
That's such an awesome tribute.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
So I don't remember.
She's a stellar person.
Strathorn sounds really familiar, though, too. But yeah. Totally supposed to be Millie Benson.
Aww.
I don't care who he is. No one breaks a contract with Bill Pappas. I'll kill him before he runs out on me.
That was a very, unconvincing, I'll kill him. Like, I'll kill him before he runs out on me.
If I feel like it.
If I feel like it. I'll send my dogs on him.
There you go.
I don't know if the real Millie saw this game before she passed away. I know she saw the first one, Secrets Can Kill. And she wrote us a letter on that.
Aww.
Oh, nice. This was one of the artists who was here too.
Nice.
His name is Tim.
Looks very happy to be there. I like it.
Rick, I'm a fan.
Say hi. Hello.
Aww. He's gone. He's not there.
It's open.
Hey, Nani.
Hey, Nancy. Glad you could make it. We'll be shooting soon, so I only have a couple of minutes to chat.
Can you tell me why someone would want to send these threats to Rick?
He's talented, handsome, and rich. Some people would hate him just for that. But Rick wouldn't hurt a fly. I have no idea why someone's trying to scare him with these threats.
So how long have you been a couple?
You mean off-screen or on-screen? You see, Rick and I dated when we were with the touring company for Romeo and Juliet.
Cool.
Do you think an old flame of yours could be motivated by jealousy to do this to Rick?
Actually, Rick and I are no longer dating. But come to think of it, I do know someone who could be jealous enough of Rick to do something like this. Yuri Danner, Rick's twin brother. I'm sorry, Nancy, it's been a running joke around here. You see, Rick's character has an evil twin, Yuri, and everyone's been saying that it's him who's causing all this trouble. But seriously, I have no idea who could be behind this. Oh, look at the time, I've got to get to makeup. Hey, why don't you come down to the set in a few minutes? I'll be shooting a scene with Rick. In the meantime, make yourself at home.
Make yourself at home? Yuri.
Ooh.
Evil twin, huh?
Dun-dun-dun.
Ooh, pictures.
Nice.
Okay, this is Chris, one of the artists. That was her. Fan letters.
Ooh,
Maddie, nice. We love you.
So happy.
I'm a big fan. It's a fan. Okay, yep.
Nice.
Cool. MJ. Maddie Jensen. A mask of sweet sincerity. A cloak of loving kindness. Meant to sway the heart to trust and fill the eyes with blindness. What?
Wait. A mask of sweet sincerity, a cloak of loving kindness, meant to sway the heart to trust and fill the eyes with blindness.
A mask of loving kindness. Ooh. Fake. What's so fake? Deceiving.
Dun dun dun. Mm. Plot thickens.
I don't know. It's a very good thing to be described, or to be, or another. We need to try calling that cell phone.
Ooh.
It's Rick's cell phone number.
Just to hear his voice.
Just to hear his voice. Puzzle. I love doing this puzzle because... Well, because I just really like puzzles. So I usually like to flip them all right side up.
That would make it easier.
Before you actually do anything. That's like step one, doing this. How many of you guys have actually played this game before?
I definitely have. This is like one of the first ones that I played with all my people. And like every once in a while we'll quote it. It's pretty great.
Do you have a favorite quote?
Yeah, definitely Millie Strathorn. Yeah. You go and meet her and she's like, it's all bad! And she sounds all crazy and you're like, oh my gosh. Oh, yeah, all the side pieces. That's like what we do for puzzles, you know. Like jigsaw puzzles, I mean. Is it jigsaw? Yeah.
And then what I do is try to fit. Yeah. There, okay, so those are all lined up.
Nice.
Okay, that goes there. That's correct, and that's. There.
Nice.
Woo. Okay, and then we try to figure out words. Ether.
Together, maybe?
Together?
Nice!
Ta-da!
Woo!
Disgust.
Disgust.
Is it this one? Disgust.
Nice.
Yes, because then it also fits down here, too.
Yeah. This bogus silver... Oh, wait.
Something, however... Where's the... H. I don't know, I can't really see the H. Can you see? Oh, there's one.
Oh, there. Yeah, because needs.
Yeah, steps. Yeah. And then needs.
Perfect.
And then you get to read this when it's done.
All right.
I don't know what that is. Oh, let's go over here. Let's go over here.
Cool.
No, let's not do that. Let's do... we can work off of these.
Cool. Let's do that. Let's see. Probably... This one probably goes up there.
This...
Yeah. It's either the or that, I think. Me. That
me. Was right. Oh, hey, look. Can and all. So,
nice.
When all.
Yep.
When. Yep.
Nice.
And then.
I bet.
And ever. Ever.
Would it be.
Everything?
Yeah, that would make sense.
Everything.
Drastic.
We sound so intelligent.
True. True dat. Alright, let's see. I bet next to the sorry is it that.
Where's that?
Right up there. There.
That looks good.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sorry that off.
That it.
Has to walk homes. Work makes sense.
Out.
Like
this?
Yeah, that looks right.
Okay, that's good.
But trust me
to
on
this, but trust me on
this.
The
yeah.
Is we both.
We both know what needs to
be
done.
Oh, but the and is pretty distinct.
Oh. Be done. And I.
Oh, ooh. That just happens right there. And
yeah, I am.
Okay, read that. Read that.
Sorry that it has to work out like this, but there is no choice at the moment. You must trust me on this. We both know what needs to be done, and I am taking the steps, however drastic, to see that it is finished, as we discussed. I just need your support. When all this blows over and everything calms down, we can be together!
Now, do you guys recognize the handwriting after we read all those love letters between Maddie and Rick earlier on the desk? You know who's... Is it lagging again? If you guys are having internet problems, refresh your browser.
Oh, there's a lot of buffering.
Oh, lots of buffering.
Oh, no!
Uh-oh. Okay, we won't continue without you. We promise. Look at how it's paused.
Nice. Okay,
let me bounce. It's about time for our break anyways.
Yeah.
So...
Cute. I love how it pauses in, like, the most flattering positions most
yeah,
of the time.
That was adorable. Yeah, look at the time, you guys. I think it's time for perfect timing, actually.
Yeah. Woo.
We are going to take a 5-minute break. When we come back, we're going to announce who the winner was of our first prize of the day.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah. No, I'm looking at the computer screen this way, but the camera's way up there. So you guys go ahead and get yourself a snack or whatever, and we will be back shortly.
Woo! Sorry, guys. Sorry you're just coming back as we're taking a break.
Yeah, well, you need Pringles. Go get your Pringles, yes. Sheeps.
Woo!
Okay.
Right.
Let me turn on some music for you.
Nice.
All right. Okay, we're back already.
Hey guys.
Come back from the kitchen or whatever if you're getting your snack.
Yes.
So just quick things before we announce the winner. Today is Throwback Thursday, and our special today is 50% off the digital download of Treasure in the Royal Tower. It's in the slideshow if you noticed it, but today only you can get it for 50% off using promo code TRT-50, like 50. And when you take off 50%, the game comes to about $4.99, which
is a pretty
good deal for a Nancy Drew game.
Yeah.
You can also gift it to someone if you think someone deserves a Nancy Drew game.
Yeah, that's a good one to start out on.
Samantha Quick, you're still in the kitchen? No, you're not. You're typing to us. Yay.
Sorry.
Thank you, Saladu. Yes, that is the code. You've got it. You've got it memorized. Okay, who wants to know? Someone actually did win.
Yes.
Hit the keyword. Tell them what the keyword was.
Keyword was address. Or address. I said that.
Address.
Keyword. Address.
Address. Yeah. Address.
Yeah, either or. But yes, and that person was HPFan0324.
Woo! Bravo.
So, yeah, so if you could private message or whisper us with your name and address, and we can send you the physical copy of Stay Tuned for Danger, unopened.
Woo! Yes, that one is for you.
Yes. So congratulations.
I saw that person type. Where is it? Oh, well, no biggie.
Yeah. Well, message us when you can.
Yes,
yeah,
private message us your name and address so we can mail that to you.
Woo.
And then we can show off the other prizes. Yes. We're still giving away a couple more prizes, you guys!
Yeah! Woo!
HP fan can't win this one, too. She can only win... You can only win one prize tonight. This one is for a randomly selected winner today.
We've got a lovely Nancy Drew journal and Nancy Drew TV show from the 70s.
Mm, woo. Yay!
Such a classic.
That will be given away at the end of today's stream. You can keep an eye out for a random selected person and write down their name.
Cool.
Throughout the rest of the chat.
Will do.
Okay, you guys, still snacking anxiety ridden? That's okay. Because you don't have to talk right now.
True.
Okay, fancy headphones.
Nice.
We got to get back on to the set of Letter of Love and, you know, read more love letters because that's tonight's mission, really.
Yes.
Is to reenact love letters.
Yeah. Get more inspiration for Hallmark cards.
So. Happy early birthday, Dragon Rider 99.
Nice.
Oops. Hang on.
Whoa.
You know, it'd be helpful if I actually, you know... switched to game viewing mode, like this. This will be helpful.
Although you could watch our faces freeze every once in a while, too. That's always fun.
G-Max, we are you heading out? Adios.
Goodbye. Thanks for watching. All right.
You just ate so many Pringles. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, no more keywords. The keyword is done for today. But random selection is happening, so...
Another script!
Woo!
Oh, Yuri, Rory's not here. I'll be Yuri. You'll be Serena.
Okay, okay.
Well, good evening. I never expected you to darken my door.
I want to talk to you about Rory. I know.
You know what? You know that yellow-bellied poor excuse of a man doesn't deserve your love, Serena. Is that what you know?
I don't know.
Of course you don't. But don't worry your pretty little head.
Wait. I know. The resolution. There we go.
Of course you don't. But don't worry your pretty little head about Rory. He'll get what he deserves, and I can tell you, my love, it isn't Serena Livingston.
What do you mean? I love Rory, and despise you. You used me to seek revenge on your brother, your own flesh and blood! And now you want to drag me down to your level. But I won't do that. I have more strength than you think.
Ah, Serena, always playing the femme fatale. Do you really think...
Don't patronize me, Yuri. I'm no longer in your power. I'm free of your evil spell!
Evil spell.
Woo.
Oh, that was it.
Oh.
Wow.
Well, she's free. That's a good conclusion. Woo.
Well done.
Thank you. You too.
Oh, I don't speak French.
Ma chérie, voici un symbole de mon amour.
Voici un symbole
de mon amour.
Pour vous.
Vous êtes.
Vous êtes.
Un envoyé.
Parlez-y pour mon courage. Pour me donner le courage.
Je vous aime.
Ami, et je vous.
Embarrasse.
Embrasse. Embrasse, not embarrasse. Très fortement.
We should be interpreters.
We're solid.
Yes. Set acting. Thank you. We tried. We put our heart and soul into those roles.
Arlen's possible departure leads to ratings questions.
No! Never!
That's not good for the show.
Tragic. Man.
Makeup. That's a lot of makeup. A lot of lipstick.
French is hard, yeah. It's a very beautiful language, but it's hard to do the and like all the all the accents and stuff.
I'm not very good at it.
Semper Ubi Sububi.
Yes! Yes. Semper Ubi Sububi. Rock and roll, dear.
Yeah. Perfect.
Lego Freak, it's your brother's birthday. Happy birthday, brother.
Happy birthday.
Of Lego Freak.
Woo! And many more.
Look, a sink.
Lovely.
Fascinating. And a soap in the shape of a heart.
Well, it is light of our love, so it seems appropriate that they'd have love-shaped.
Lots of soap. Soap and perfumes. Oh, right. We were supposed to get to the stage.
Yeah, we're going to watch something.
Things happen.
Woo. Let us in.
I need something to make this work.
Yes, no, you. Yes. That's right. That's right.
I need something to make this work.
Come on,
I need something to make this
there we
work.
There we go.
Places, everyone.
I'm so
are we
excited.
Locked in?
Yes, Miss Wise. We're clear to shoot.
Have we blocked this already?
Yes, I think.
Quiet on the set.
I would hope so.
Is the floor ready?
Check.
Audio. Check.
Roll tape.
Stand by camera one.
Stand by music.
Take camera one.
Rory, I have to talk to you.
I don't want to see you, Serena.
No, Rory, don't go. I love you.
I don't want to see you, Serena.
Oh. Sheesh! What was that? I could have been killed. Get my agent on the phone, now.
Aw, sad Rory is sad.
Everybody.
Looks like Rory, I have to talk to you.
I don't want to see you, Serena.
I don't want to see you, Serena. I love you. I don't want to see you, Serena.
They're going green by recycling.
What a lovely tea set.
It is beautiful.
Clean through.
Wow. Not rusted or anything.
And the cleaning crew totally took away the light,
comedy.
But not this thing.
They're very efficient. That cleaning crew. Best part of the game.
Yes. I know, it's so great. I like how the stairs lead to nothing.
Maybe it's like...
That's a set for you.
Maybe it's like platform 9 3/4.
Exactly.
Mystery loves company.
Mystery loves company. This horse is seen in many Nancy Drew games.
Ooh. It's a lovely horse.
A cozy place to sit.
Indeed, this is a nice home. I have to talk to you. I don't want to see you, Serena.
No, Rory, don't go. Your time is running out, regardless. You better kiss your career and your life goodbye because the end is near.
Ah! Over days. That's why he said the same thing again, because they ran out of normal lines for the teleprompter.
Oh, yeah. Like, I have to go back this ways. Set design. This is where I would love to work.
Yeah. It's always so interesting to look at, like, the behind the scenes of different movies and stuff and see how, like, what goes into production. And sure.
I'll take this.
They don't need that.
I'd rather take these, but, you know, whatever.
It's weird to carry that around, you know?
Yeah, that's like, true. You would look a little bit suspicious.
Maybe just a little bit.
Magazines.
I carry nice saws little... with me when I go to the store.
Bagels and orange juice.
Let's eat.
I'll take it.
Nice.
Okay, camera blocking. Maid comes in, stops here, comes around with the tea. Serena comes in, stops here from the door. And sit down. Rory starts here and then sits down. Sit down together. And they have tea.
Ooh. Doesn't sound too bad. It sounds like a pretty chill scene.
More blocking. Backlights. Rory's around. Nice. Scribbles.
The wheel is stuck.
Oh no.
Warning. Authorized WWB personnel only. Catwalk ladder must remain locked and up position when not in use according to policy code. Wait, what? All non-compliant personnel will be automatically terminated without severance and escorted off the premises.
Wow.
Well.
Sounds a little harsh.
I need to find the key for this.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, we do.
Yep. Ooh. Look in the cam. Why is this cameraman focused on the clock? Does it bug him that much?
He's just bothered that it's a nice clock. Who really knows?
I should set the clock.
Really?
Good 13.
For you,
Nancy.
Whoa. 13.
There is no 13.
I should set the clock.
Unless it's minutes. I guess there's 13.
Well, that's a weird number to go for.
It is kind of weird. That's like Friday the 13th kind of thing.
Yeah. How do I get out of here?
All right.
Things. Ooh, this is for extra wind.
Ooh. For all the scenes in the house where there are extra wind.
Where you have to
come
out the
door right outside.
You know. Pretending you're outside. Ooh, let's go over here. Let's go over here.
Let's go upstairs.
Oh. Electro lock.
I like it.
It's locked.
Nuts.
Should push all
Nancy right. goes down the stairs backwards the entire way. Did you notice that?
Yeah.
Back. Oh, just slide down the rail, Nancy. If you're gonna do it that way.
She was moonwalking. She's a descendant of Michael Jackson. Ooh, what's this?
On Time Express.
Nice.
I can't read what that says. I don't even know what that is. But it's the worldwide broadcasting.
Apparently it's all 33, 54, or 59, so. I don't know.
Hmm. Well, in case of emergencies, you can either take a hacksaw or an axe or a giant water hose.
Woo!
I'm gonna go with a water hose.
Oh, same.
I think that would be fun.
So much more fun.
East wing.
Nice. What's in the west wing?
Maddie and Rick.
It's open!
My favorite line of the whole game.
Hello there. Oh, are you a visitor? According to the policy's memo dated July 14th, 1954, no one is permitted in the prop room, except for those people permitted in the prop room. You may want to talk to the director, Lillian Weiss, if you want to become permitted. She likes to do all of the hiring around here. Good day, my dear.
Millie, my favorite character ever.
That's like the nicest getting kicked out.
I know.
Goodbye that I've ever had.
Yeah. I wouldn't mind if someone said that to me. I'd be like, okay, yeah. Oh, I will leave. I will do that.
That's totally bug the director.
Lillian Weiss.
May I help you?
Whoa.
Yes, hi. I'm a friend of Maddie's, and I'm. Do I look like a tour guide?
Yes.
Look, the set's closed to visitors. I'll need to take your pass away. But if it's any consolation, I'll be more than happy to show you the door.
Wow, someone woke up on the wrong side of the prop room.
I'm gonna be obnoxious.
Oh yeah, you kick me out, I'll knock on your door. You won't get anything done. dig that.
What kind of studio are you running here? My client could have been killed.
I told you I'd get to the bottom of this. I've already closed the set to visitors.
All right. Well, that's a problem.
That is a problem.
It's open. Oh, Nancy, this is horrible. There's no way that could have been an accident. I think it's another attempt to get Rick. The timing's just too weird. All of these threats, and now he's almost killed on stage. I'm too upset to deal with this. I gotta get out of here. I need some space. We'll talk later.
Winkford Castle, how utterly rude.
Yeah. Obviously she's upset.
I'd be a little upset, I think.
I'm your biggest fan.
Entrevue.
Entrevue.
Woo, here we go.
Oh, my. Look at that hunk.
Hello, gorgeous. Where have you been all my life?
Okay, how old is he? How old is he supposed to be?
I figure early 30s.
That's
late,
a little creepy.
20s.
That's a little creepy.
River Heights?
Touché. So, you're an old friend of Maddie's. She told me you were coming up to visit. She said you find me irresistible.
Oh, I do find you irresistible, Rick.
Actually, I find those letters you've been getting irresistible. I just love a good mystery.
Oh, you're no fun. Well, mi casa es su casa. You know, my house is your house. Well, feel free to examine the evidence, Miss Drew, while I go off the wardrobe. Have a chocolate while you're at it. Stay beautiful.
Stay beautiful.
Well, we certainly will. Thank you, Rick. So dreamy.
Well, if you won't be mine, you won't be anybody's.
Whoa!
Somebody's jealous.
That's a little creepy.
I'm tracking your every move. Watch out. I'm right behind you.
BZ Kaiser.
Kaiser. I could go for a Kaiser roll.
BT Kaiser. Hey, this is probably the same person that was cutting out stuff from the magazines in the lobby.
Yes, BT Kaiser. I wonder if a security guard ever caught sight of him. Leave Latimer alone.
Wow.
Okay. Cola. Take his money! And his keys!
Quickly!
Look at his old-fashioned cell phone.
Yes, HP fan 0324. Yes, you won the prize. So, yes. So, private message us or whisper, and then tell us your name and then your address, and then we can send your prize. So, yeah. Which was the game. You get this. Congrats. So, yeah.
Yes.
It was soap opera journal. Steal the mug. Okay.
Serena's miraculous recovery.
Oh my.
Something must have happened. Real life couples. How I became a star. You can too. He doesn't look happy being fake married to whoever this is.
No, he does not. He looks like he's ready to run away.
He looks like he's gonna cry. I'm going to get you, Rick. Your days as Rory Danner are numbered.
BT Kaiser. Man.
Look at this soap. Jabon. Looks fancy. Jabon.
Ooh.
Fascinating sink.
Nice. It's a lovely room. Oh, more notes.
This one's burned.
Dear Mr. Arlen, I just want to write you and tell you how much of a fan I am, of course.
One moment.
Uh-oh. Wow.
I totally failed to do something during our stream. So I'm gonna play a little music for you.
Oh no.
And I'll be right back. I mean, you guys can still hear us talking and all, yeah. But I need to fix something, obviously.
Oh, I see.
This, right?
I think it's this. Yeah. That's a drag. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's okay. I completely forgot to change this out.
It's hard to remember, you know.
That's tight. I can't rotate it. I don't have to go over here.
It's locked.
It's locked!
We are experiencing some technical difficulties. Oh, I'm just gonna throw that on the floor as well.
favor and shut the door.
Yeah, for sure. I bet.
Makes the evil twin brother ruin the stream. Yes, it was Yuri's. It was Rory's twin brother Yuri who is sabotaging this. Ah! Don't trip over the wires.
Careful.
And then we do this thing.
Oh my gosh.
Let's do a test run real quick.
You can kind of.
Yeah, it'll have to be like this.
Well.
Okay, we do sort of fit like that. So that's how it's gonna have to be.
Yep.
Let me turn the music back. And then we'll get back into the game.
Nice.
We're having a minor camera difficulty, so we're going to both fit into this one right here.
Excuse me. All right, here we go.
Okay, we were reading this burned note.
Yes. A fan of your impending doom! I can't wait until that fateful moment when, as I watch you squirm and beg for mercy, cheese. But I won't give it. You don't deserve it, you coward! And don't think I'm not serious. I'm serious enough to keep a close eye on you. How did you enjoy your meal at Blake's last night with that trashy woman from Nash Cove? You ordered a red wine with your halibut, you fool! And then fell asleep in box 42 watching Soft Shoe! Then I ended with a taxi ride to your boat and slip 83, afraid that I know of your secret hideaway. Maybe one day it'll sink with
you.
Resolution notice. There we go. With you in it! A fanatic.
Fanatic.
Yeesh. I think this fanatic needs to get a life.
I don't know how I feel about him having an X-Acto knife open right there. I always keep X-Acto knives in a safe box that doesn't rattle around or stick anybody.
Yeah, you know.
Your time is running out.
Jeez.
It's me, your faithful fanatic, with a dropped Y. Or am I now a lunatic? That's what you called me yesterday with your little group of followers. It's just one big joke to you, isn't it? Yes, Rick, it's a joke. And I'll be happy to deliver the punchline. Right in your face.
Oh!
I think Rick, if he could remember when he said he was talking about that person, then he could probably narrow in who wrote that note. Paparazzi photo faves. Look how glamorous he is. In a red shirt, you guys.
Whoa.
Do you prefer red shirt, green shirt, or white shirt?
But a red shirt reminds me of Star Trek, where all the red shirts die off. So.
That's true. Oh, he got awards too, so it's not like he's actually bad. Scared you, didn't I? Good, because this was just a dress rehearsal. Only my revenge is truly sweet for Garland, so prepare for your long and bitter end.
Cute.
Dead roses.
Oh, no.
Black roses. Ugh.
Such a waste.
Anybody want to play golf?
Let's do it.
Yeah.
Skip mystery solving, let's play golf.
Let's take a close look at his wonderful set of golf clubs.
Nice. I think I saw another script.
Oh, yes, yes.
So pretty the chocolate.
No, I can't.
Oh.
How do I loathe thee? Let me count the ways. I loathe thee to the depth and breadth and height my soul can reach. I want you out of sight. For the ends of vanity and ideal conceit, I loathe thee to the level of everyday's most quiet need. By sun and candle flame, I loathe thee freely as you strive for fame. I loathe thee purely as you cannot turn from praise. I loathe thee with a passion put to use. I can't read poems. In my old griefs and with my childhood's faith, I loathe thee with a hate I seem to lose with my better dates. I loathe thee with the breath, smiles, tears, and all of my life. Of all my life. And if it comes to pass, I shall only love thee well after your death. Wow. So, Pressa Chocolates.
That sounds like a very familiar name.
Welcome back, Happy Puppy Harley. Die, Rick.
Whoa.
He ate one.
Oh. Bummer days.
We should at least bite into each one and find out what's inside.
I agree. But who would do that to chocolate, you monster?
I can't ruin chocolate. I wish Nancy could just, you know, taste it. But if it's poison, then, you know.
Yeah.
That would not a good idea.
Yeah.
Oh, cool. Stereo.
Oh, my goodness.
Your time is running out. Broken clock.
This person just has an excessive amount of death threats. Rick, do you think that I'm stupid? You sent your boat up to your upstairs cabin. I know where that is. And I know where your Fifth Avenue penthouse is. I even know the access code. Change it. That won't stop me, because one day I'll meet up with you. There's no escaping my wrath. I'm much nearer than you think. Ooh.
Okay, Omer. Chris was obviously an artist in here.
And a fan of Rick Garland.
25th annual soap opera. Yeah. He got it. He won it. Did I miss anything in here?
Did we check all the drawers, all the tops, tables, all
no,
that?
I didn't. Well, of all the random things to take, I'll take that. We need to take his keys.
I know.
And his stamps.
All this useful stuff.
The Hamptons, me and my gal.
Nice.
That's probably the coolest outfit I've seen him in yet.
No, very trendy. Mm-hmm. Like the necklace.
It'd be weird if I really was a fan. I'd come in here and I'd take something weird, like his comb. Be like, I got Rick Arlen's comb.
This touched his hair.
It touched his hair. I think I hit everything.
I think so. You're probably good. All right.
Okay, I need to go bug Maddie again because, oh my goodness, it's late. I can't even go out the door.
No.
Talent, exit.
Oh, there we go.
Hey, taxi!
Where to, lady?
7226 Lexington Avenue, please.
On my way!
It touched his hair!
It's locked.
Oh, thank you.
Ned Kong, yeah, I read that note. She's gone? What time is it?
Probably abducted.
It's only 6:45.
What? She didn't go to bed, did she?
Huh. Well, I can't really do anything right now until I see her, so you know what?
Well, lame potatoes.
I guess we'll go upstairs and change it today. Because that's how Nancy Drew's life works. You change it today. There she is!
Woo!
Hi, Nancy. I'm sorry for skipping out on you like that. I guess I'm not a very good hostess. It's just that this whole thing with Rick really shook me up.
I understand, but now that the studio's closed to visitors, I'm at a dead end.
There's got to be a way to get you back in the studio. Whoever's leaving these threats for Rick also has access to the studio. Wait a minute, I've got an idea. You know, my agent could get you a job as an extra so you could get on the set. You don't have to do anything. They just need to have people standing by.
Nice. That sounds great. But what should I say if they ask about you and me?
Just tell them you're an aspiring actress who I've taken under my wing. I'll give Dwayne a call first thing tomorrow. Just stop by there in the morning. Mm-hmm. I'll tell him you're an old family friend who's decided to try out acting as a career.
Oh, that'd be great. Thanks, Maddie. Well, I'm sure you've got to rehearse for tomorrow.
Yeah, I should get back to learning my lines for tomorrow. Good luck.
She may be terminated. Yeah, if you don't follow all those rules there, we'll terminate you on spot. Mm-hmm. It's a pretty extreme set.
Mm-hmm.
Anxiety ridden. Yes, we turned the iron off. We won't be second chance.
Yeah, we're not, yeah. Ooh, write this ooh. Number down. Write that phone number down. It's 212.
212.
555.
555.
2900.
2900. Bam.
So if we go
it's
back inside
locked.
The house,
we can go call him.
We can try to call him.
Let's do it.
Oh, sorry, I had it memorized.
That's okay. Now I know. I'll study it and remember it forever.
You've reached the Powers Agency. Interviews are only taken by appointment. Thank you.
Okay. Appointment. You've got it memorized too, classic Nancy Drew. Let's go see him.
Taxi!
Yeah, what's the address?
318 West 10th Street, please.
You got it.
Cool.
All these buttons.
I know.
When I first heard this and played this game right here, I'm like, oh, well, what do I do then?
I know.
I don't know what to do. I'm stuck.
And then I would just click on everything else.
Don't you understand?
Mr. Powers, Maddie Jensen sent me to see you about a job as an extra.
I'm sorry. I'm in Suite 101. Come in.
That hurts the ears.
Yes.
I know, buzzing is annoying. I actually looked up this address on Google Maps again, and it's kind of in a sketchy-looking area of New York. I mean, it's not bad, it's just not as clean.
Ah.
Powers, talent. He's, like, down here in the basement.
I know.
Yoo-hoo!
Make some about.
Make some about.
I apologize for my abrupt greeting. You must understand that if I opened my door to every struggling actor in this town, I'd never be able to get my work done.
Oh. Well, you're forgiven. You have a friendly face.
I'm sorry, you guys.
I'll be happy to meet with your assistant if you're too busy.
Actually, I am in need of an assistant at this moment. I had to terminate my previous secretary. I'm afraid that my standards are rather high for most people.
I'm a friend of Maddie Jensen. She told me you might be able to get me a job as an extra on Light of Our Love.
Ah, yes. Maddie just called me. You're Nancy Drew, am I correct? Maddie spoke highly of your abilities, and I am more than happy to give a young actor a chance, if I can. Thanks. Normally, I don't do this, but seeing that you're a friend of Maddie's, I could pull some strings for you. You see, Worldwide uses me almost exclusively for hiring their talent. Not only did I provide them with Maddie Jensen, but Rick Arlen as well.
Cool.
How long have you known Maddie?
Maddie and I go back over 8 years. We met doing summer stock at the Belfry Theater upstate. She went on to play Juliet with a touring company, and I started this agency.
Nice.
You're Rick Arlen's agent?
Oh my
yes,
God.
I was. But I must confess that the man has no talent.
All right.
Were it not for his good looks and charm, he'd never have gotten to where he is now. You see, Rick foolishly believes acting is a status symbol, not an art form. He's a ladder climber who'll use anyone to crawl his way to the top. A ladder he's sure to fall from one of these days. Well, Nancy, you must be anxious to start this assignment. I'll call right now and have a pass waiting for you at the reception desk. Now, if you'll please excuse me, I must get back to work. It was a pleasure meeting you. Please call on me for any other needs you may have.
The man has no talent.
How do you really feel?
Yes, in his right shoulder, he clearly works it out a lot.
Mm-hmm.
A lot more than, you know, his left.
His door is right down the hall, right over there. And then if you go up the stairs, right over there.
Transformers, anyone?
Yes! Oh my goodness. You got that? Bumblebee.
Well, can I take your day, miss?
1999 Broadway, please.
Oh gosh. too good.
Can I help you?
Hi, I've been hired as an extra by the Powers Agency.
Here you are. You'll need to sign for it. You'll need to come to this desk every time you enter so I can log you in.
All right, fair enough.
Ooh, new sign-up list.
Patty Tate.
Tracy Trent. I don't know any of these people.
Me neither. I like Lonnie's handwriting.
Where?
It's like the third from the...
Oh, yeah. Lonnie.
Is it lonely or long? I don't know.
Because that was like an egg. I don't know.
Thank you, and good luck.
Thanks, man.
Okay, let's. Who do we bug first?
Let's bug.
I want to bug Pappas. The producer.
Aw,
darn.
It's open.
All right, Maddie.
Maddie, I got a
Hi,
job.
Nancy. Glad to see Dwayne could get you a job as an extra. Who knows? Maybe you'll be the next Serena Livingston.
As if. I'm lucky if I can remember my stage left from my stage right. Dwayne was very helpful. I can't believe he got me a part, just like that.
Dwayne's a great guy. He gave me a chance when no one in this town would even give me the time of day.
Aw. Good guy, Dwayne.
I don't think Dwayne likes Rick very much.
Actually, the feeling's mutual. Dwayne was Rick's agent and helped him get the part of Rory Danner. But later on, Rick ditched him to go with a larger agency. I guess to help him get out of his contract here.
Hmm. Well, I'll see you later, Maddie.
Be careful, okay, Nancy?
Okay.
Okay.
Yoo-hoo!
Madison!
He's gone.
Ah.
Okay. What were we supposed to do now?
We should go... Can we talk to...
Let's go talk to the crazy lady.
Yes! My favorite!
It's Opie!
Yay! My dear. Hi. How can I enter the prop room?
I see. Well, I don't just let anyone enter my prop room without showing me that they're clever enough to take on the responsibility.
You have to be clever to take things.
To my riddle, when you know the correct answer, I'll let you in. When you look at my face, it's easy to see. You're looking at you when you're looking at me. What am I?
Okay, guys, do you remember what the first answer is? Go ahead and shout it out.
And it is.
Wait for it.
Here.
Oh, that was pretty easy.
Yes.
Let's try another one. Soft as a petal that falls from a tree. The more I dry, the wetter I'll be. What am I?
It's funny you guys mentioned. Oh, look at that. Everyone knows I'm here. How about this one? You guys know this one? I saw you guys mention the voice. This is actually the same actress who voiced Nancy in this game. She's just playing the part of an older lady.
Yeah.
Lonnie Minnell played the voice of Nancy and Millie here.
Very good. Let's see if you can answer one more. I run all day and never walk. I tell you something, but I do not talk. What am I?
Either one works.
Ooh.
That's it! I have stumped many people with my riddles, but you are quite the sleuth. You may go and enter the prop room now, while I go and unpowder my nose. Achoo!
Achoo!
She would be such a fun grandma.
Yeah. She's crazy, but she's great. Okay, you guys, I think now is actually the perfect time to call it a day. Because this prop room has a lot of things I need to share with you. What should we save our game as? What should our names be?
It's Open or The Man Has No Talent.
I like that. Oh, I can't do exclamation points in here.
That's okay.
There.
Oh man.
Oh, you guys, it's time to give away a prize.
Yes.
Woo. Is there anything else that we're forgetting before we give this away?
No, we mentioned the sale.
We mentioned the Throwback Thursday, 50% off Treasure in the Royal Tower tonight only. Kevin Bacon. What?
He knows. He's had the time of his life.
She's also the voice of Lulu, yes. I know the party's over, but we're going to have a really long day tomorrow. You're going to have to actually make some good progress. She's going to be playing tomorrow.
Yep.
I did a lot of reading. So she's going to be doing a lot of actual story movement. We're going to have to go through it pretty fast because we spend a lot of time wasted.
That's okay. It was fun. I think it was fun time.
Tomorrow, we will ask you guys what game we should play next. And I'm thinking... Start thinking about it now, what game you'd want us to play on a Twitch party in the future, because the next time it'll happen in October, so think scary game.
Yeah.
That would be the most appropriate. We'll take your votes tomorrow, not tonight. But anyways, have we randomly selected a person yet?
Did, yes.
We did. We have randomly selected, through the chat feed tonight, a lucky winner of the prize pack.
Yep, let me get that up.
Here, right here, I'll hold them.
Oh, there you go.
And
yeah.
You announce the winner.
Woo! So you win these things! And the lucky winner is...
Drum roll, please!
That's the greatest drum roll ever. Yeah. Drew Lock 99!
Yes. Are you still here, Drew Lock? Congrats to you. If we don't hear from you via a whisper or a private message, we'll get back to you. But we need your name and your mailing address. You don't have to post it here in the chat, but your name and mailing address so we can send you this prize.
Woo-hoo.
Congrats, you guys. And we'll be playing this game tomorrow at the same time, 4 o'clock Pacific time here. And...
Or excuse me, sorry, that was Drew Lock 96. I think I read the wrong
name. Did you read it wrong?
Oops. Oh. 96, 99, it's all relative.
Drew Lock, are you there? I didn't even notice if you posted.
I saw, yeah.
So it's locked.
That's my mistake entirely.
Yeah. Anxiety rant. I like your name, Unicorn Princess.
Nikki. I know, it's kind of fun to see all the names that come through the feed. It's like, all right. It's, well, I thought it was 99, but I could be wrong. It could have been 96. I don't know how many Drew Locks there are out there.
Yeah. But, and, oh, there it is!
Oh.
96! Drew
okay,
Lock 96.
96. Yes!
Yes! Congrats!
Woo! Okay, good, yeah.
Okay, yay! Great. Awesome. Yeah, and, tomorrow we are, there's the camera. Tomorrow we are giving away more prizes, so come back.
Yes.
You guys have a good evening. We will close out now with a little bit more music.
Stay beautiful.
Stay beautiful. We can do the same time. Three, two, one. Stay beautiful.
Oh my goodness.
This is just so fabulous.
I know. Oh man.
Good night, you guys.